It was a cold and rainy winter night. The funk of hopelessness, loud and dried urine, was everywhere. The posse of militant mofos put on their skull war paint and got baseball bats ready for the union meeting. It was time to take the union from the sellouts and give it back to the members. They quietly arrived in buses and motorcycles, surrounding the union hall. Then they kicked down the doors and the sellouts dropped their crack pipes and ink pens. Before the guilty traitors could scatter away like roaches, the militant mofos blocked the doors and opened duffel bags full of garlic and mirrors. They flashed the mirrors and the sellouts cringed in pain. They fell to the ground like scared dogs. The sellouts screamed and begged for mercy as the garlic made them cough and gag. One scrawny-looking weasel with a mustache kept pounding a little wooden hammer while shouting, "Out of order! Out of order!" "Shut up!" interrupted one of the militant mofos. He wore steampunk goggles, sunglasses, and a mask resembling Bane from The Dark Knight.
What do you want?"
the weasel squeaked, flinching as the garlic odor stung his lungs.
"Who are the lawyers?"
The weasel pointed out a pale trio of two men and a woman that nervously smiled. They were dressed business casual and had blood dripping from their fangs. Before the militant mofos could capture the lawyers, they leaped through the windows, holding briefcases with the words "tentative agreement" on them. The militant mofos chased the lying piece of union lawyers through Washington Park and toward Lake Michigan. Seeing Facebook Live videos about the rebellion at the Union Hall, Mayor Lowley and Boss 33% called the police union chief Copenbara on his private line to beg for assistance. All they got was voicemail.